Well, hello, chaps. It's Commodore Grayum here, and I bet you weren't expecting to see this, were you? Well, I sort of changed my mind, but sort of not changed my mind about TerraFirmaCraft. Now, I think what the problem is I was essentially forcing myself, whether I liked it or not. Much of the time I did like it, don't get me wrong, to make two videos of this game per week. Now what I'm doing is I'm switching to playing it when I feel like it. So, today I feel like it, so we're going to continue on our epic, I don't know, epic quest for survival, I suppose. I've packed up all the stuff that I need. Whoops-a-daisy. You can tell I'm not used to playing this because I tried to press control to sprint. That's a no-no. That ain't going to work. Maybe I should be eating something. My sandwich keeps popping out there. Well, maybe I don't need to eat anything else. But anyway, what we're going to try to do right now, if I can get over my just general incoherence, is travel back to our base. But during the course of this in-game day, I think we're probably, am I uncovering new land here? Am I just going in some random, right, where are we trying to go? We're trying to get to shit shack number 11 and we need to go northwest. So let's do just that. Have we marked down this tetrahedrite? We have not. Oh god, the distractions are starting already. I think, if I remember rightly, I was marking down ores in yellow. Okay. Let us continue northeastwards. So, yes. I think what happened is I just kind of, I thought, oh god, I'm going to have to make, I'm going to just have to keep making two episodes a week of this stuff, grinding away, whether I feel like it or I don't. And that was entirely the wrong approach to take to my YouTube channel. Also, I felt kind of bad letting down all the people who watch these videos, because of the videos that I make regularly, like my regular series, TerraFirmaCraft gets the most views. And, well, what does that equate to? It equates to people deriving enjoyment and satisfaction and value from whatever the hell it is that I'm doing. Ooh. Hot springs. I was told that they oh god, my speakers are on. Hopefully there's no weird echo going on in the sound effects before now. So we need to get over this. Yeah, I was told the hot springs heal you when you sit in them. Although we don't need healing right now. So that's immaterial. Let's try and negotiate our way down here. All is well. Okay, so I suppose we can head this away. Ooh! Try and avoid going in the water, because we'll probably only have to readjust our ambient sounds when that bug makes them leap back upwards in volume. Okay, let me check the map to make sure I'm not just crazy here. Yeah, I'm going in the right direction. We're good. Well, I mean, you know. Now, people sometimes say about certain YouTubers oh, they're only in it for the views. Which I mean, like, I can understand where that's coming from. Oh, do we want this? Maybe we want this. We're really low on space. I can understand that from the point of view of, oh, I'm just going to do whatever I can to get views, and I don't care at all about what I'm doing. But there's more than one reason why a person might want to get views. It's partly because you... Oh, hello. More malachite. I guess I should mark that down. You might want, your channel to do well and eventually become sort of successful venture. Although, let me tell you, you need to be getting a very large number of views for that to occur. But, The other thing about getting a lot of views, or getting some reasonable number of views, is that presumably what that means is that you have been of service to a large number of people. Which is a very satisfying thing, to be honest. You know, like, if I make a video and someone lets me know that it's really made their day, or helped them get through the day, or they were entertained, or it made them laugh or smile or anything like that, that's just so nice, you know? Like, it makes you feel... Well, it gives you a sense of meaning that you might... not otherwise have access to. I'm just picking up sticks, apparently. I suppose there's no reason why not. Just watch, I'll get caught by a bear whilst I'm picking up sticks. So, I don't know. Like, I've always been the sort of person who finds it... Oh, we need to adjust our course. I've always been the sort of person who finds it quite difficult to get excited by the notion of, like, money or fame or attention or anything like that. To be honest, like, I'm not very materialistic and I'm pretty introverted. Not that I think there's necessarily anything wrong with someone being extroverted or in caring more than I do about... Caring more than I do about money. I mean, you know, money's important. Sometimes I wish that it was something that I cared more about, because I might find myself in a better situation in certain ways. Apparently I'm combining these lemons. I don't know how that makes any sort of earthly logical sense. But what does give me a sense of meaning is knowing that I've done something that meant something to someone. Like, even if I never meet them, it's just a very nice feeling. Okay, so getting these is going to enable us to make a whole load of vinegar, aside from anything else. I still have to try to get to... Well, I'm very close to my shit shack, so we should be able to... Oh, god damn it. We should be able to get there. I'm going to get more or less a whole stack of lemons here. So, yeah, the point being, I know that a bunch of people got a bunch of enjoyment out of these TerraFirmaCraft videos that I was making, and that is, that's certainly a factor, you know? Like, partly I just, I was like, I kind of feel like playing this game a little bit again. I have to use a saw for this, don't I? Is that what's going on? Or not. Am I going to guess that? Am I just completely confused? Have I just forgotten what I'm supposed to do here? Oh, I think it'll. Maybe they only sometimes drop saplings. Well, in any case, I didn't get any. My apologies to anyone who's face palming right now. In case I just did something incredibly stupid. I mean, I can't carry all that much stuff anyway. Right, we need to get some sustenance inside us. Then we need to run. Oh God, why am I overburdened? Why is this not in my backpack slot? That was really weird. Okay, run. Bugger. Right, this way. It's probably still going to be a bear around here somewhere. And relax. Right. So, we managed it. Let's get rid of some decay. So we got a ceramic bowl dumped back into our inventory due to finishing off a salad, I suppose. Tell you what. Let's make another. Oh, it popped in there automatically. That's fine. So let's see. What do we got? Tomato, pork. Oh, right. Okay. And honestly, that should probably be enough to see us through the rest of the journey. Yeah, that works better, doesn't it? Okay, so I'm going to cut until daytime. Wait a minute. I guess we need to. No, it's not lumber. Oh God, I've forgotten everything, haven't I? We need. I'm going to run out of space here. Curses. What can I put down for now? Random basalt rock. Okay, that's fine. And actually, now that I think about it, maybe we should make ourselves two bolts, just in case one breaks. Probably more than that, even. Yeah. So I need, what, three of these? And we're going to have some leftover lumber, unfortunately, leftover planks even. I'm just going to put that down. That's fine. Oh Christ on a bike. There we go. Job's a good one. Right, now I'm going to cut until daytime. Back in a moment. Okay, then. It seems to be becoming day, more or less. So, I think it's about time for us to get the effing H out of here. So, here's where I am right now. I gotta needle my way through there. Head back up the coast and get back home. Surely we can achieve such a thing. Alright, let's run for it. Okay, there are no mobs particularly close, and... Wait, what? Where did my other water jug go? Oh, I guess they sometimes break. That's fine. That's fine. We're tanked up, so to speak. Oh, oh no! Oh my good lord. Where are we? We were literally a few blocks from the sea there. Then we would have just had to boat back home, and that's it. Job done. Oh, these trees have grown a bit. We still have 3 cows, that's great. Okay, what do we... Oh. What do we need? Tannin. Sake, okay. Yes, what do we need in order to get our stuff back? We need a water jug. We're going to need ladders. More ladders than that. Oh, this is going to be tricky. It really is. Because you can't do the gravel trick. Because the gravel piles up. We might need a pickaxe to dig down. Well, hold on. Let's think about this. This is the only pickaxe we have available to us, so I guess we'll have to take it. What food do we have? Let's just grab some cheese. That'll do. Probably. Let's not grab all the cheese. Let's not do that. That would be a silly thing. Maybe we want... Where on earth did I have everything? Maybe we want a few blocks. Do we want a shovel? We don't strictly need one. We are going to need a boat. Which means... hang on. We should expand our crafting square once again. Okay, we have lumber. We're good for that. Wait, we don't need that much. Boop-a-doop-a-doop. Oh. Oh, but though, but. We're going to need sticks to make the ladders. So, how many ladders do we want? How deep did that ravine look that I fell into? I'm just going to make all the ladders. I hope that's enough. We probably want some solid blocks, don't we? So that it's actually... Oh, no, no, no. We can use... If we need to pillar... We can use logs for that. As a matter of fact, we can use planks for that. Oh, that was unbelievable. Okay, give me that. Let's just make all the planks. Right, well, I'm going to... Well, we might as well make more boats just in case. And then, let's see. Right. Okay, that's probably enough planks. Actually, if we grab the hammer, because I'm thinking to try to get a whole bunch of sticks, right? And the quickest way that I can think of to do that is to smash up logs with a hammer. So let's see. We got one stick from that. Seriously? These logs are not being very generous with the sticks right now. Yeah, this was a terrible plan. Probably we'd be better off just breaking leaves to get more. But... I'm going to hope that 20 ladders is enough ladders. It probably is. Let's face it. Right. So we have food. In the form of tasty, tasty cheese. We have water. Actually, do I have... Oh, what did I just do? Never mind. Probably it makes more sense for me to use seaweed as the food source here, because it's less valuable in that it's easier to get. Now, so this can go away. We have food, water, some blocks. I really don't need to be taking this with me. The pickaxe we may well need. The saw we definitely know. Definitely nope. I think this is everything. Okay. And now, ladies and gentlemen, you're going to be treated to a time lapse of me getting back to where I dropped off all of my stuff. Enjoy! Thank you. Well, chaps, here we are, just off the coast from where we died in the middle of a dark and gloomy night. Very dark, very gloomy. The sun is in just the wrong place by reference to the orientation of the moon. And at this point, we're just going to have to wait until it gets light, because there is no way in heaven or on earth that I am venturing forth into this inky pitch blackness. So, I looked at the minimap there for a second, thought there was a spider coming across the water towards me. Perhaps not. Wait, this is fresh water? Really? I would not have expected... Oh, wait, no. Yeah, it is. I would not have expected that. Well, there you go. So, time-lapse over, I guess. I probably sped that up really rather a lot, because it was extremely uneventful and lengthy. And now I'm just going to cut to daytime. Okay, here we are. Daytime is rather suddenly upon us. It got light extremely quickly there. Now, let's see. I believe it was somewhere around here that we died. Wow, does the water just end at the ravine? That doesn't make much sense. But okay. Yeah, it does. Yeah, I was literally a few blocks from salvation before getting completely nobbled. Left shift, of course it is. Right, first thing is, okay, there's a zombie here, but hopefully he's going to just automatically get nobbled by the daytime. Yes, indeed. Now let's be very, very careful. Oh, I just saw a mob down there as well. And I don't know if it died or not. Look at this. Look at this. Look at this deadliness here. Right. So I guess what happened is we... Oh, don't lag. We just walked right over here. Okay. Here's how we're going to do this. Carefully, that's how. I mean, we don't have a shovel, unfortunately, which is going to impede our speed. But that's okay. We don't have too many dirt blocks to break through, hopefully. Right. And as we go, we're going to make our escape route. So if there are any mobs down here, we should be able to escape. What would be particularly horrible is if a skeleton or a javelin wielding chap accosted us with his bellicose and hostile presence right now. It's looking a little bit like maybe we didn't even need to bring the pickaxe, but we weren't to know that it was going to be soil and gravel all the way down. Well, not quite all the way down, seemingly. I am taking no chances whatsoever here. Ladders all the way. Okay. Okay, we have a staircase all the way down. Firstly, check for mobs. I do not like this dark area here. So let's... Oh, whoops-a-daisy. Let's at the very least... Oh, bugger. Make it less likely that mobs will see us by blocking that up a little. Okay, looks safe over there. Safe over here. We can grab our stuff now. Come on. Right. Time to sort everything. Okay, we have the barrel on our back automatically. Don't really want this spare dirt. There's a bunch of other stuff. We can put this on. Sticks, we'll get rid of those. Gravel, we can make more. We have some more stuff we want to pick up. Let's see. Eh, we've got lots of dirt. We can get more sticks. We can certainly get more logs. And there's still a prospector's pick and something or other else here as well. Oh, a mace. Nice. And we need to drop one more thing. How about this little bit of flint? Okay, good, good, good. Holy crap. What a lot of utter nonsense that was. Come back! What? Did you see that? It was like the boat didn't want me to board. It was running away from me. That's the last thing we need. Uncooperative and sentient boats. Seriously. AI is getting far too far in this day and age. Right. Ooh, and we got some lag. Okay, so... Oh, we needs to eat. Let's get ourselves back home by means of yet another time lapse. Maybe this one will be even more ridiculously sped up than the last one. Let's find out. Well, oh God. Oh my God, I can't believe that just happened. I apparently looked at an Enderman, or at least I heard an angry Enderman sound. Oh wait, what? And I'm also getting periodic lag. I don't know what's going on. But we're back at home, clearly. These plants seem to have just died or something, just leaving seeds behind. I guess I left them too long? I don't know what time of year it is. Okay, let's... Jesus, what's going on with this lag? Let's get... my apologies for the stuttering and freezing here. Let's get ourselves back into our lovely, lovely shack. Hope that we don't get an Enderman teleporting in and murdering us. And take stock of the situation. Right. Do we have somewhere to keep gems? We kind of did. That's great. Oh, we have some kind of decay going on here. But is this too decayed? We can't eat it now. Is that what's happening? Let's try this manually. Yeah, that didn't work. Yeah, it seems that even though I'm not really going anywhere right now, the game keeps freezing and freezing and freezing. I don't know why. But anyway, we're back. We actually managed to get all our stuff back, so even if we died right now, all our stuff would be right here. So we've got that going for us, which is nice. Is there any stuff we can put away? I suppose there is. There's probably quite a lot. Oh god, it's such nasty lag. Usually, as I'm sure you're aware, things work a hell of a lot better than this. So, got a little collection of prospectors' picks right here. Let's just clear the inventory as much as we possibly can. We've really got rather a lot of tools going on here. Oh, I'll tell you what we can do. We can take this off our back, plop it down, and seal it. And here we have all of our bounty. Lots of kaolinite. More lots of kaolinite. Marble, which is going to give us flux. A whole bunch of different sorts of seeds. Berries, rock salt. A lot of meat. Yeah, we really did get all the things, did we not? Oh, yeah, we mined up a whole ton of coal as well. That's going to be pretty damn useful. Have you stopped lagging yet, game? No, you have not. So, I guess I'll keep my saw on me the whole time. Actually, I'll keep this mace and the axe on me, because that's what I need for fighting, depending on what I'm fighting, that is. Rock salt goes in here, I suppose. And I guess at this point, I'm wondering whether to cut the episode short. Well, I have no idea how short or long it's going to be, actually, if I stop right now. I'm wondering whether to cut it short simply because of the terrible lag problems that I'm having. Because that might be annoying you just about as much as it's annoying me, to be honest. So, yes. Well, that was a bit of a shit show with the random falling into a ravine and dying. Hopefully it provided you with some amusement. And hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you did, ladies and gentlemen, do not forget to click the like button. It helps out rather a lot. Share this video with anyone you think might be interested or entertained. Leave your thoughts and suggestions in the comments section below. And subscribe if, but only if, you'd like to see more. Ta-ta for now, chaps.